gonna do some shed hunting and see what I can find.
Well, right there's where the big 6-point was standing in muzzleloader season that I filmed. I was standing right out in there, and he ended up walking right along here and up that hill. So I'm just gonna walk back and forth, and this is kind of a squared off piece with the field and a four-wheeler trail on the side. So I'm just gonna mark this as my little zone, and I'm just gonna walk back and forth and see if I can find anything. Trevor actually found a shed right here last year on this trail, so.
I just spooked a whole bunch of deer. There's at least 10. And I'm thinking there was a buck in that group. Yeah, that looked like a buck. It looked like a little spike. They're going right back where I came from. I was hoping to head down into these pines. They were all laying right here, right along the road. The road is just on the other side of those pines, and that's where they're laying. So, hopefully, if there were any buck that still had their antlers, they just dropped them right there. Walking through stuff like that, and stuff like that, everything looks like an antler, plus it's sunny. This might have been a bad day to shed hunt.
Well, we're with Trevor and Nick, and they got some sheds that they found. Tell us tell about your shed hunting this year.
Well, it's been real slow this year. It really, actually, it wasn't even 3 weeks ago, we still seen deer at the antlers. There's so much underbrush now that we're not finding them this year. I mean, last year we had an awesome year, so maybe we jinxed ourselves last year finding all them ones. And I found these two, and Nick found that matching set.
About my house in cornfield. I had side by side. Not a real big one, but.
You guys were on the four wheeler, weren't you?
Yeah, we were found them on the four wheeler, just driving through the field. Trevor goes, "But we could find 12 sheds in this field," and I was like, I just laughed. After driving through the field, I found this one, and this was laying about 10 feet from it, so. Found both of these this year, and found those two.
Seen this buck in archery season, and we got pictures of it, but I bet we just spent an hour going through 5,000 pictures, and we can't find the trail camera picture of it. So, and it's the first bear I ever whacked. Guys all get on me because I'm obsessed with them, and finally killed one. She weighed 95 pounds live weight. Got her back in 4 months. I'm real happy with it. It looks real good. So, Alan Reichard mounted this for me. So, anybody had any questions and
did a good job.
Want to have anything taken to him? Just let us know, and I'll get you a phone number for him. And from there. So.
Get the biggest shed you ever found, Trevor.
Okay. Found this one 5 or 6 years ago, just right below the house. One guy, I guess you call him a neighbor, doesn't live real far from here. He's seen it. The only person I ever talked to had ever seen the deer. And actually, we scored it, rough scored it at 83 inches on one side. So, whatever happened to him, I don't know.
You can see how it's brown here. You just saw the points sticking up right there. You can kind of see the.
It was down the ground.
It was covered with leaves, you know, this whole top. I picked it up and I couldn't believe it. So, that's a nice shed anywhere, if you ask me, let alone.
Oh, yeah,
Western
especially.
PA.
Yeah, in PA.
So, gonna go do a little bit of fishing now.
Well, I'm out here another day and hate to find this, but.
Yep. Little 7 or 6 point legal buck. Hate to find those. Hopefully, I don't find any more.
Well, here's another one.
Well, that's a nice year and a half old buck, too. That's 2 dead legal buck. I don't even want to walk around anymore in case I find any more of them. Hate to see that. Still no sheds.
Well, it's February 28th. Just gonna do some quick shed hunting. Not all the bucks have lost their sheds yet, but it's too nice of a day. It's probably 45. Me and my dogs need some exercise, so just gonna walk out top of a flat where I know a lot of deer like to be. My feeder's up here, so we're gonna check it out and just walk the trails. Hopefully we can find a shed.
Well, here's my feed that I feed the deer. It's a horse feed, actually, from the mill in town. It just has some corn, soybeans, oats, just some different horse feed in it, you know. So, but it's not that much more expensive than just corn itself, and you're able to give the deer some extra food, and I just like to feed them and put my trail camera on it and see. I don't have my trail camera out right now.
Well, walking through the thicket here and on a leaf has some blood on it. Found some blood on a rock here. That's a fairly used trail. I come up from that way. Now the trail also goes around the hill, but you know, when bucks lose their horns, antlers, you know, they will bleed. So hopefully that's what I did discover, is some bleeding. So I'm gonna search this area pretty hard. It's thick as all get out, really squatchy, so I gotta watch out for Bigfoot also. But hopefully I don't run into him and I just find the shed. Well, I keep finding blood, but looks like it runs down there where my dog's coming out of. I just physically can't get through that. That is really thick. So the only thing I can hope is it's behind me and not in front of me. So I'm going to turn around and try and walk some trails the other way. And maybe I'll get lucky, or maybe something, but it looks like pretty fresh blood. So, if you ever let a balloon go and watched it soar into the atmosphere and wondered yourself, where does it land? Well, somebody obviously let the I Love You balloon go, and it landed here in the middle of the woods on a deer trail. So, I just, maybe you guys don't wonder, but I wondered every time I let a balloon go where it's gonna go. I'm walking a big soybean and corn fields. Been seeing a lot of buck up in here. Pretty nice 8-point, obviously. I want to find his sheds, but I did manage to find one so far. Just a little 4-point. He's out. So we got one. We'll say one guy's up. But there you go. There's one down. Hopefully not the last one of the year.
All right. So this is the one I found on March 9th. This is when I was only about 20 miles into my walking. I walk quite a bit. It's the only shed I found. Sometimes you can't be lucky. This is the shed my dogs found, so they're more skilled than I am. It's just a little, probably 2.5 inches. Just a little nub. So, the only two sheds that I found. Makes for a nice little buck, if you ask me.
Well, we're shed hunting. There's a morel right there. Trevor found like 6 so far. There's another one I just seen.
Got one.
Better than finding the shed, huh?
Oh yeah. Found another one.
Starting to find a bunch. Once you find one, you usually find some more. He's picking one there.
Two now.
There's another one right there. We got a wee little one.
I bet your brother. Your brother found some over there.
Got a wee little one right there. We're just gonna leave it go. Yeah, go ahead and pick out one. And there's two more right there. So we're gonna have a mess full of them, it looks like.
I know, I need a haircut.
That's a big one there.
Another big one right here.
There's one
right here.
One further down there. Where's that little one at? Right there. These are a black phase of the morels. You see the pretty dark colored. There's also yellow phase. They come out later in the year. And actually, these are the earliest we've ever found them. Usually around trout season, you'll start finding the black ones. But it's been warm and stuff like that this year, so they came out early. And come turkey season, you'll be hunting the yellow ones while you're turkey hunting. But probably have 20 or so far.
I thought I'd throw some of these trail camera pictures up. My dad puts the trail cameras out after deer season, and this is up in the pines near my rifle stand. Here you got the back end of a fisher crossing on the Gaswell Road, and this was in February. There you can see a little buck in the background. This is up on the hill. This is 30 yards away from where Shane caught the coyote in trapping season. There you can tell there's a shed buck right there. Got a lot of little bucks, spikes and Y's and 6-point sheds, and haven't found any sheds, but I know they're out there somewhere. They're just hard to find this time of year when everything's getting green. And there is a coyote. This is probably the male that was running with the female that Shane caught there in trapping season. And there's a nice little red fox there. This coyote is down right below my rifle stand on the pines on the Gaswell Road. And good thing turkey season is just right around the corner.